سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Beloved seekers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Alhamdulillah, our gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having able us to be here for the 17th day in Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, very fast already we've passed the 15th mark, and yesterday was, in fact today is known as the Yawm al-Badr or Nuzul al-Quran. It is the day of Badr. Alhamdulillah, yesterday we managed to recite the 313 names of Asma Ahl al-Badr. And I hope, you know, may Allah accept us, accept our du'as with the virtues of the Ahl al-Badr, inshallah. And still in the readings of Siyar al-Salikin, Bab on Fasting, we are now at Laylatul Qadr. So it's, I think it's very nice. We are entering almost the last few nights. This Sunday will begin the first odd nights of the last 10 nights of Ramadan. So if you are feeling tired, now is the time to take on a bit more energy food to carry on, inshallah, and to feel happy because Allah has granted you to meet the last 10 nights of Ramadan, inshallah. And Allah has brought us open up for us thus far, so we should maintain whatever Allah has given us. Hopefully we can meet Laylatul Qadr, inshallah. And these are some of the signs of Laylatul Qadr or some of the teachings about Laylatul Qadr. It's narrated from Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu an, from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yani Laylatul Qadr is in the fourth likur from the month of Ramadan. Basically, the fourth of the odd night. So 1 to 10 odd night. So the first odd night is number 21, 23rd, 25th. According to Sayyidina Bilal, is 25th. According to Sayyidina Abu Darda and Hassan al-Basri, Imam al-Hassan al-Basri, great Abu Darda is great Sahaba. Sayyidina Hassan al-Basri, great Tabi'in, Imam. He says, and it's also on the 5th. So it will be the 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th, according to Imam Hassan al-Basri. So this is a popular opinion that the 27th night of Ramadan. So if you're talking about you're talking about Laylatul Qadr, there are many different opinions. So some opinion says, you know, you have the 25th, some say it's the 27th, some say, you know, it differs, okay? According to Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas, and Sayyidina Ubay ibn Ka'ab radiallahu an, that the Laylatul Qadr is the 7th likur, so the 29th night. And this is dan inilah yang mu'akkad pada mazhab Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. And this is the mu'akkadah for Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. So, oh sorry, the 27th night as well. 27th night as well. And this is according to Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani in his book Al-Gunya. So what do we need to do is we need to be on our toes on the odd nights of the last 10 nights. So, of course, the best is to be in a state of i'tikaf for the last 10 nights of Ramadan. If we are not able to, at least, what can we do? Okay, the question is maybe someone asked, what is it can we do for the last 10 nights? Simple thing. Increase doing your tawbah prayers, number one. And number two, do sunnah tasbih. I think this is really sufficient. If you cannot do anything else, at least do the tawbah prayers and sunnah, solat sunnah tasbih. It's really, really important. And of course, your tarawih, because we cannot do tarawih in Rajab, cannot do tarawih in Muharram. Tarawih is only done in Ramadan. So try your best to keep to your tarawih prayers. So one of the tricks is to always be on guard with your isha prayers. If you can do isha prayers, best of course in with a jama'ah and the congregational prayers, and then at least you would have received Laylatul Qadr, inshallah. At least some parts of it, inshallah. So keep to that and do your tasbih prayers. So tasbih prayers, I highly encourage it. So if you can do it as well, inshallah, that'll be very, very good, inshallah. Let's read on what the Sheikh has to say. He says, and about the dalil, it being seeking for Laylatul Qadr in Sunnah Mu'akkadah, it comes in a hadith from Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal radiallahu from Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar. That means this hadith is through the son of Sayyidina Umar, Abdullah ibn Umar. He says, لا يزالون يقوسون على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رعيا أنها ليات سابعة من العشر الأواخر. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رؤياكم قد تواترت أنها ليلة السابعة في العشر أو آخره. ومن كان متحريا فيتحرها ليلة السابعة من العشر أو آخره. رواه إمام بخاري. يعني The companions of the Prophet, yeah, they were very yakin, yukusuna ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the Prophet riwayat to them, the Prophet narrated to them that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would dream about Laylatul Qadr, and he had dream about it in the 27th night. And it is in the last 10 nights of the Ramadan. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned, I see in my dream that verily the night of Laylatul Qadr is on the 27th night in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Therefore, whoever who wants to own Laylatul Qadr or to be part of Laylatul Qadr, make them a chase for the 27th night. So this is really important. So I know some of us, sometimes we're working shift, we're doing this, we're doing that. But try to make some time, because it's once in a lifetime. Yeah? We don't know when is the next Ramadan we'll see. So if we feel that this Ramadan, we're doing quite okay, alhamdulillah. So then work towards the last, the 27th night. That is the main night, according to Shaykh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani, Qadisullah Sayyidina Aziz, and Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, from the hadith narrated by Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar. Yani the Prophet said he had dreamt that the nights of Laylatul Qadr was the 27th night. The question, normal question would be, is it fixed? Well, it's not. But it's usually we're supposed to really be praying. And you can see this in a lot of cultures. I think we might have lost this, especially in COVID in Singapore. We see this a lot in the Middle East, some parts of the Middle East. Egypt, we see this a lot in India as well, Pakistan. The 27th night is like a celebration of prayer. So sometimes we don't connect the two together, prayers and celebration. Sometimes we think prayers are a burden, and that's our problem in today's world. Working is not a burden, but prayer is a burden. Klaka. So we should always be celebrating in our prayers, in that sense. You know, so celebrate that you're able to pray. Celebrate, and prayer itself is celebrating. What are we celebrating? The glory of Allah. What are we celebrating? The glory of being the servant of Allah, and the honor and glory of being the servant of Allah. So it is very, it really is a celebration. So the 27th night that is coming. So this is the time, you know, where we get a lot of, in the past, our parents will make us dress with new pajamas before we go to sleep, etc. It is celebration, you know. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would adorn himself in these nights. He would really, you know, like how you would welcome a guest. That's how you would welcome the night of Laylatul Qadr. You know, he would bathe. In fact, it's sunnah to bathe after every maghrib, after every iftar. Sorry, not after maghrib. After iftar, the Prophet would take a shower. Why does he do so? To be refreshed, to welcome the night of Ramadan. Of course, we're tired with our children, etc. But the nights of Ramadan are expensive. I was just sharing with our students, some of them yesterday. So we did Taraweeh, alhamdulillah, some of us lah. Yeah? We were talking to them about Taraweeh lah, basically. So I was saying, you know, it's called Taraweeh because it's supposed to be done bit by bit. Why? Because before Taraweeh was made 20. Yeah? And for me, I believe Taraweeh is 20 lah, yeah, for me. Because Sayyidina Omar and Sayyidina Ali come to a consensus that it's 20. And we never knew how much the Prophet did. Actually, we know. How much did the Prophet pray? The Prophet prayed until his knees were swollen. So that is the sunnah of prayers. It's not 8 or 20. He prayed until his feet were swollen. So people in Mecca, how did they do Taraweeh before it was made 20 raka'ats? was that the first four rak'ats would be reciting Al-Quran from Surah Al-Baqarah to Ali Imran, maybe the first four chapters. Imagine that. So that's why they had to rest. And their resting was that they did tawaf. And that's why it makes sense then that Taraweeh was done bit by bit. But for us, Alhamdulillah, we're doing small surahs. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr, and then we recite another short surah, and then we stand up and do. We don't need to like rest, yeah, in that sense. Our problem is we're not resting from too much ibadah, we're resting from too much dunya. So even in Ramadan. So what I'm saying is, of course, we need our dunya. But 27th night itulah kita try. Must be really semangat lah. You have to be really have the excitement to meet the 27th night of Ramadan. More so than having the excitement of Eid. Why? Because in that night, inshallah, we'll be gifted with 1,000 months of worship. Mana nak dapat? So of course we say, oh Ustaz, I worship to Allah ikhlas. I'm not asking for reward. Good. If you're not asking for the rewards, then all the more we should be doubling up our game, inshallah. You get what I'm trying to say? Not because of reward, then all the more every night we won't sleep because we're not praying for rewards. We're praying for servanthood. So don't misuse that statement. A lot of people say, oh yeah, I'm not looking for rewards. I'm not looking for pahala. I'm looking for, you know, just to be in the presence of God. Good. To be in the presence of God means jangan tidur, jangan makan, all that, go all out. Don't say we live in a time of darurat, we cannot pray so much. All the more, we need to pray even more. Ask Allah for shifa, ask Allah to lift the bala, ask Allah to protect us, etc. So we just need to be very, now we are in our own doing ibadah, inshallah. I hope it also arrives a certain sense of contemplation and reflection when we're doing our ibadah. So let's work hard for the next few days. That's going to come, inshallah, as a reminder to myself as well about the importance of Laylatul Qadr, inshallah. So at least do, you know, if you cannot do much solat, at least do zikr. If you cannot do, if you cannot read Al-Quran in that sense much, do your zikr. If you cannot do zikr, then be in a state of shukr. There's nothing else we can do. You know, the best thing for us is to be in a state of zikr. And to be in a state of shukur, to be staying up, not to sleep. Because why we stay up, not to sleep? Because the malaikat are going to come down. In the hadith we'll read in the next few days, inshallah, that speaks about that. How Sayyidina Jibril would command to the different malaika on the nights of Laylatul Qadr. And how we would feel the presence of Sayyidina Jibril, alayhi salam. These are all the gifts, the ni'mah that comes in Ramadan. Yeah, so if you have been given some amal by your sheikh, keep to it. If you've been given some amal by your teachers, whatever it may be, keep to it. In this last 10 nights is the nights that we should be really keeping to our ibadah, making a lot of dua, general duas and even personal duas. It's not the duas from the books only, but the duas that comes, that arises from the heart. It's been mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ, when he made dua, it is like a cauldron that is boiling, mashallah. The intensity of the Prophet's dua. And the Prophet, when he made dua, it is not, you know, it's been mentioned by Sayyidatina Aisha that light will appear. How does light appear when the Prophet made dua? These are some of the narrations of the importance of dua. So I hope, you know, our asr sessions will build up to the nighttime ibadah. Even if it means spending time with your family in a state of having a meal and all of you are thankful. Itu pun ibadah. You know, treating your family, I've mentioned this a few days ago. Treating your family, that is also ibadah. Being kind to your family, taking care of your family, calling, making a dua for your family. All these are good ibadah to do on these nights as well. So it's not only about the self, sebenarnya. It's also like it's prophetic to be praying for people. And the Prophet never prayed for himself. He always prayed for people. Pernah Rasulullah cakap, ya Allah, grant me this. The grant me this is usually for the ummah. It's never for him. He has everything. He has Allah. And he has mentioned another hadith, verily Allah gives and I distribute. Allah gives to him. He's the distributor. So we want, wherever it is, follow his way, make salawat on him, get the barakah in these last 10 nights. These last 10 nights, the best person who knows how to handle Laylatul Qadr is none other than Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So if we're able to keep to our salawats as well, take out our Dalailul Khairat, recite the salawats on the Prophet, be making a lot of sadaqah. So sadaqah can help you to do ibadah. When we do sadaqah, it relieves the burden of the sins and it lightens the body to do ibadah. Make dua, oh Allah, with this sadaqah, allow, lighten me to worship you. You know? So these are some of the things we should try to do in these last few nights of Ramadan. Before you know it, it's going to leave us already. And when it leaves us, we have to do what the companions did. For the next 6 months, they prayed, oh Allah, accept this Ramadan from me. Accept this Ramadan from me. And the following 6 months, oh Allah, allow me to see Ramadan, mashallah. And so if we have not felt what the companions felt, is because we have yet to feel the mysteries and the blessings of Ramadan that is yet to be unveiled to us. So ask Allah, oh Allah, unveil the blessings and the greatness of Ramadan to me. Unveil it for me, ya Allah. And inshallah, I really feel it will come, inshallah. So one of my practices for Ramadan is when Ramadan comes, I have a set of readings that I try to do. So it's my Ramadan readings, and sometimes it's a collation of articles, or of course not political. My readings all have to do with, in that sense, the journey of suluk and all these kind of things. There's also a lot of barakah in that. When we try to revisit the knowledge of our teachers in the month of Ramadan, number one. Number two is I try to take a specific amal and I keep it for about 30 days or 40 days. So for that next 30 to 40 days is my seclusion, in a sense, a mini seclusion. And that's my nasiha to all of my murids as well. And try to do plenty of istighfar, plenty of istighfar. That's the best remedy for Ramadan. So there is the personal ibadah, then there's the ibadah with the community, there is the ibadah, you know, you in your ibadah, your personal ibadah, you bring in the presence of the people that you make dua for, and you send this dua to them. You in tasawuf, we call it tawajjah, you know, we send this tawajjah to them. But usually the sheikh does that. But for us, we can intend that this dua is being received by such people. May Allah make us generous with our du'as, inshallah. Ameen, ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya khair, alhamdulillah. So that's the opening section of this thing. I think I've exceeded a bit. Let me pass with this thing. I say exceeding it. Let's begin with the four statements that we should recite. Yani the statements to not make this practice a mundane, or to make any practice a mundane practice. You know, it can be prayer, but we're not present. We can be eating at the same time, we can be present with Allah. And we do that, number one, by reminding ourselves, by saying this to Allah, oh Allah, assist me in reciting this afkar, this zikr. You can do this for anything. Assist me in making tea, assist me in preparing the meals. So we say, assist me, ya Allah, in reciting this zikr. Number two, oh Allah, facilitate me in reciting this zikr. Number three, O Allah, allow me to complete this zikr with safety and afiyah. Number four, we say, O Allah, accept this zikr from me. Alhamdulillah. With that as our guidance, inshallah, let's move to the next one. It's our intention that we can recite daily. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Follow after me as well. I intend to be a humble servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to commit to the work of healing myself all around me and to the earth, to draw strength of peace, mercy, compassion, and love from all states of ibadah, wajib and sunnah, to clarify my soul, mind and body by observing this intention and the act of dhikr in every breath that I have been given. I seek blessings, guidance and protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and those who made this intention with me. Let us begin, inshallah, by connecting ourselves with the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, by reciting and gifting this Al-Fatiha to him. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Al-Fatiha ila Hadratin Sayyidina wa Mawlana wa Habibina wa Shafi'ina Rasulullah Sayyidina Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shay'un lillahi lahumul Al-Fatiha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Malik Yawm al-Din. Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. Let's make the opening dua, inshallah, dua iftitah. Yeah? And the essence of this dua is that we're asking, O Allah, with the rank of Holy Prophet, cleanse our heart, cleanse our soul, and accept our deeds, inshallah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم يا رب بجاه نبيك المصطفى ورسولك مرتضى طهر قلوبنا من كل وصف يباعدنا عن مشاهدتك ومحبتك وعمتنا على السنة والجماعة والشوق إلى لقائك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله with the blessings of Sayyidina Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم may our hearts be filled with his nur inshallah amin ya رب العالمين let's begin by seeking refuge in Allah from our waswas, from all of the whisperings of shaitan, inshallah. A'udhu billahi as-sami'i al-alim min ash-shaytanir rajim. A'udhu billahi as-sami'i al-alim min ash-shaytanir rajim. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم لهم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله السميع العليم الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور والذين كفروا أولياؤهم الطاغوت يخرجناهم من النور إلى ظلمات أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. Alhamdulillah. Let's take our right palm and put it on our chest, inshallah. And for the next two recitations, we hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open up our hearts to be receiving more light and tajalli from these verses of Al-Quran, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our iman and our taqwa, inshallah. So put your hand, your right palm on your heart and follow me in reciting this verse. We recite the first one 3 times and then the following one just once, inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
هو الذي أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم ولله جنود السماوات والأرض وكان الله عليما حكيما هو الذي أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم ولله جنود السماوات والأرض وكان الله عليما حكيما هو الذي أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم ولله جنود السماوات والأرض وكان الله عليما حكيما بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب.
Can blow into your chest. Ya Allah, grant us sakinah fi qulub and expand our hearts like how He expanded the heart of our Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Yeah, Ameen. Let's recite the mu'adhatain inshaAllah.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس.
الحمد لله. We've just finished the Quranic recitations, inshallah, and we now move towards the Allahumma salli, the prophetic recitations, inshallah. And so I hope this many weeks that we've been doing this, I hope we felt a certain connection with the presence of the Holy Quran, inshallah. And we understand that reciting Al-Quran brings a lot of peace to the heart as well. And this is the month. In reciting Al-Quran, there is istighfar, there is dua, there is a lot of things. We just might not understand it, but it is there. Everything is there, inshallah. Yeah? Let's recite the prophetic du'as, inshallah, for the mornings and afternoons, inshallah.
Allahumma inni amsaytu ushiduka wa ushidu hamalat arshika wa malaikataka wa jami'a khalkika annaka antallah la ilaha illa ant وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك اللهم إني أمسيت أشهدك وأشهد حملات عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك اللهم إني أمسيت أشهدك وأشهد حملات عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك اللهم إني أمسيت أشهدك وأشهد حملات عرشك وملائكتك وجميع خلقك أنك أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت وحدك لا شريك لك وأن محمدا عبدك ورسولك اللهم بك أمسينا وبك أصبحنا وبك نحيا وبك نموت وإليك المصير اللهم ما أمسى بي من نعمتي أو بأحد من خلقك فمنك وحدك لا شريك لك Allahumma bika amsayna wa bika asbahna wa bika nahya wa bika namut wa ilayka al-masir. Allahumma ma amsa bi min ni'amati aw bi ahadin min khalkika fa minka wahdaka la sharika laka falaka alhamdu wa laka shukru.
This one, this dua is, the translation is Allahumma bika amsayna. Okay. O Allah, by you we enter this afternoon and this evening, and by you we enter the morning. So that's why we recite it, Allahumma bika amsayna, if we're reciting it after asr. If we're reciting this in the morning, it's Allahumma bika asbahna wa bika amsayna. So you pray for the. So this one we're praying for us right now in the afternoons, in the evenings, and we enter the morning, that means to come. That is the next time that we're going to see is the morning. So we're asking Allah with Him, with His protection. By you we live. And that means by with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we live, and by you we die. Allahumma bika asbahna wa bika amsayna wa bika nahya wa bika namut. So we're not wavering anywhere else. We're focusing and grounding ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ilaykal, and to you we return. And to you we return, and oh Lord, the blessings that I've received in these mornings or in the evenings, or from those received from your creations and from you, as it can only come from you alone, and to you we have no partners or gratitude, only coming to you, yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a dua that we ask Allah for blessings and His presence in the day and the morning. And this is taught to us by Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So may we preserve this dua, inshallah. It's a well-known, mashhur dua of Prophet, and has a lot of tawakkal in it as well. A lot of, sometimes we do things, we forget that Allah is the one that is taking care of time. Time is something that, of course, it's the 12 hours and all. Everything is in the hands of Allah. So sometimes we feel that our day doesn't have enough time. Ask Allah, you know, by you, Ya Allah, I enter in the morning, by you, I enter in the evenings. And if you want the barakah of time, make sure you don't sleep when the sun is rising. And that causes a lot of heaviness in the day as well. So when the sun is rising, try your best not to sleep. You can sleep right after that lah. Yeah. So for us, shuruk is about 7:08, around there. After that, you want to rest, marhaba. But these are some of the timings that the Prophet has mentioned. Not observing these timings can have effects on us, physically, mentally, spiritually juga. So do not sleep after Asar, mithal. Unless it's you really need it, that you really cannot walk anymore, lah, that kind of thing, mithal, you know. Then take a rest, but not go into a deep sleep. These are because the Prophet says sleeping after Asar can cause craziness, can make us go crazy. It does something to the mind. Wallahu a'lam bissawab. Let's continue, inshallah.
اللهم علم الغيب والشهادة فطر السماوات والأرض ورب كل شيء ومليكه أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أعوذ بك من شر نفسي ومن شر شيطاني وشركه وأن أقترف على نفسي سوءا أو أجره إلى مسلمين لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم اللهم عافني في بداني اللهم عافني في سمعي اللهم عافني في بصر لا إله إلا أنت اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الكفر والفقر اللهم إني أعوذ بك من عذاب القبر لا إله إلا أنت اللهم عافني في بداني اللهم عافني في سمعي اللهم عافني في بصر لا إله إلا أنت اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الكفر والفقر اللهم إني أعوذ بك من عذاب القبر لا إله إلا أنت اللهم إني اللهم عافني في بداني اللهم عافني في سمعي اللهم عافني في بصر لا إله إلا أنت اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الكفر والفقر اللهم إني أعوذ بك من عذاب القبر لا إله إلا أنت اللهم إني أعوذ بك من اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن وأعوذ بك من العجز والكسل وأعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل وأعوذ بك من غلبة ديني وكحر رجال اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن وأعوذ بك من العجز والكسل وأعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل وأعوذ بك من غلبة ديني وكهر رجال اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن وأعوذ بك من العجز والكسل وأعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل وأعوذ بك من غلبة ديني وكهر رجال We spoke about this a few days ago that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم even in his rest He would recite this dua, Ya Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-hazan. It's important for us to identify the difference between laziness and tiredness. So laziness is definitely a trick of shaitan. Yeah? And tiredness is something which is the requirement of the body to rest. But laziness is when we're able to do something and we don't want to. And there's nothing stopping us at all. And, offering the extra two rakats of prayer, offering the, reciting the extra piece of the Quran, etc. Are we lazy or are we tired? If you're tired, fine, have a rest. Yeah? Because the body also has rights on you. But if we're lazy, then that's another thing. But so we need to know the fine balance between how hard do we push ourselves and at what point do you need to rest. So ibadah must give rise to happiness in a sense. Of course, when we reflect a lot about what we've done in our sins, it will give rise to remorse, lah, which is natural. But after that, we should switch to happiness, yani contentedness. Lah. Maybe happiness is too dunya, eh? Joy, eternal happiness that we are we've given these blessings to remember Allah. We can be watching TV right now, but we took time away from our TV. To be in a state of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for that, we should feel happy. Nah? And when we feel happy, then the things that hinder us doesn't look so to be, becomes easier for us as well. Yeah? So joy, lah, basically. There's a difference between joy and happiness. Happiness, if it's not understood properly, it can mean temporal happiness. But joy brings something which is more permanent, more eternal in a sense. So the eternal joy here, eternal happiness or eternal or joy is when we are doing something for the hereafter. And like the Ahl al-Badr, we know what they went through and, you know, 1,000 malaikas came down to support them on this day. So the same. So they
They could have just stayed and never mind, let the Quraysh do whatever they wish to do. No, Prophet ﷺ migrated. He got help from the different Bani, Khazraj, and all of the different people to help him to save the Ummah of the Prophet. So we shouldn't be Ummah that lazy, because we are the best of Ummah. Kuntum khayra Ummah ukhrajat linnas. We're the best group of Ummah that has been sent by people, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may we overcome the acts of laziness and the insights that makes us have illusions that we cannot move forward in the path of spirituality towards Allah. Let's recite the next dua.
بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم.
What you do now is you blow onto your palms and wipe over your whole body, inshallah. With this, may Allah grant us shifa and protection throughout the night until the following day, inshallah. Ameen.
A'udhu bi kalimatillahi tammati min sharri ma khalaq. A'udhu bi kalimatillahi tammati min sharri ma khalaq. أعوذ بكلمات الله تمت من شر ما خلق اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شيطان الوسوسة الخنزب اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شيطان الوسوسة الخنزب اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شيطان الوسوسة الخنزب.
Subhanallah, for this dua, put your right hand, your right fist on your heart as well.
Subhanallah al-Malik al-Quddus, al-Khallaq al-Fa'al, in yasha' yudhibkum wa ya'tim bi khalqin jadid, wa ma thalika ala Allah bi'aziz. Subhanallah al-Malik al-Quddus, al-Khallaq al-Fa'al, إن يشاء يذهبكم ويأتم بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله بعزيز سبحان الله المالك القدوس الخلاق الفعال إن يشاء يذهبكم ويأتم بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله بعزيز سبحان الله المالك القدوس الخلاق الفعال إن يشاء يذهبكم ويأتم بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله بعزيز سبحان الله المالك القدوس الخلاق الفعال إن يشاء يذهبكم ويأتم بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله بعزيز سبحان الله المالك القدوس الخلاق الفعال إن يشاء يذهبكم ويأتم بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله بعزيز سبحان الله المالك القدوس الخلاق الفعال إن يشاء يذهبكم ويأتم بخلق جديد وما ذلك على الله بالعزيز.
May Allah expand our hearts, inshallah. Let's recite the next dua.
لا إله إلا الله علي الحليم لا إله إلا الله رب العرش العظيم لا إله إلا الله رب السماوات والأرض ورب العرش الكريم يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك أستغيث وأصلح لي شعني كله ولا تكلني إلى نفسي طرفة عين الله الله ربي لا أشرك به شيئا اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وعن عبدك وعن على أحدك ووعدك ما استطعت أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت أسبحنا وأمسينا أسبحنا وأمسى ملك لله والحمد لله لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير ربي أسألك خير ما في هذه الليلة وشر ما بعدها ربي أعوذ بك من الحسد وسوء الكبر ربي أعوذ بك من عذاب في النار وعذاب في القبر اللهم إني أسألك العافية في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم إني أسألك العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا وأهلي ومالي اللهم استر عوراتي وآمن روعاتي اللهم احفظني من بين يدي ومن خلفي وعن يميني وعن شمالي ومن فوقي وأعوذ بعظمتك أن أختل من تحتي اللهم إني أسألك من خير ما سألك نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذ منه نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت عليك توكلت وأنت رب العرش العظيم ما شاء الله كان وما لم يشاء لم يكن ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم أعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علما اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شر نفسي ومن شر كل دابة أنت آخذ بناصيتها إني ربي على صراط مستقيم. Let's end with reciting salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hopefully, with through this small effort of ours, we can receive the shafa'a of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ونبيك ورسولك نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزا الله عنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هو أهله. جزا الله عنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هو أهله. جزا الله عنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هو أهله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. استغفر الله. نسألك الجنة ونعوذ بك من النار. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. استغفر الله. نسألك الجنة ونعوذ بك من النار. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. استغفر الله. نسألك الجنة ونعوذ بك من النار. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا كريم. الحمد لله. Let's raise our hands and make dua inshallah. We ask Allah with the virtues of all of that we have recited and whatever hajjats you have, and one of the du'as, ask Allah to grant you the Laylatul Qadr, the energy to look for Laylatul Qadr, the guided spirit, what to do, what to look for in Laylatul Qadr, what the ibadah, may Allah open up for us, and du'a for your parents, your family members, etc. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد النبي الكريم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله. We've come to the end of today's session. الحمد لله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of your du'as inshallah and make this session inshallah a fruitful one, and may we be given the ability to do this in a state of istiqamah until the very end of this month of Ramadan, inshallah. And hopefully by the end of this month of Ramadan, some of the du'as here will be something which is already lazim with us, that we can able to carry this even outside the month of Ramadan, inshallah. So I'd like to thank all of you and for tuning in. Thank you very much. And it's nice to see all of you here. Keep us in your du'as. Keep this online virtual du'a circle in your du'as as well. We hope to see all of you tomorrow. And if you like to support us in the work that we do, I just sent you the link for Being Center's donation page, and the donation will help Being Center in the work, in rental, in all of the things that we do lah. Yeah, so thank you, and have a beautiful, blessed iftar, and we see all of you soon. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Waalaikum salam. Thank you, Mushid.
Thank you. Who is that?
Kak Rafida.
Oh, Rafida, okay, good. Nice.
Yeah, it's been too long already. Nice to see and hear you.
Yes, I hear you too as well. Rest well. Have a good time.
Okay.
Salam. Thank you, Mushid.
Oh, is that Naura?
Yes.
Oh, how are you, Naura?
How are you, Naura?
I'm good.
She's good. Oh, okay, good. Naura, rest well. Looks like you're fasting, alhamdulillah.
I'm not fasting. Drinking milk.
Yeah, that's her fasting lah. Dia from this bottle to the next bottle, she's fasting in between.
Okay, say bye-bye.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Assalamualaikum. Salam sejahtera, Farah.
InsyaAllah, yes. Alright, bye, Mushid.
Bye. Thank you, everybody. InsyaAllah.